Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Logic Medico. Today's topic for presentation is inferior longitudinal muscle of the tongue. It is one of the tongue muscle. So let's see this muscle. If you are new to my channel, kindly subscribe to my channel and press the bell button to get the latest notification of the videos. So let's start with the tongue. As such, has got an attached portion which is called the root, and this is the tip of the tongue. There are two lateral borders. On upper surface is called the dorsal surface and the lower surface is called the ventral surface. So in this tongue there are two types of muscle or two groups of muscle. Extrinsic muscles, they begin from one or the other bone of the skull and ultimately reaches the tongue. They alter the position of the tongue within the oral cavity. Whereas intrinsic muscles are those muscles which are there within the tongue itself. They alter the shape of the tongue. So the intrinsic muscles are superior longitudinal, which is in the upper portion, longitudinally oriented. This is the base and this is the tip. Inferior longitudinal muscle, this is today's topic. Inferior longitudinal is just parallel and below the superior longitudinal. This is the outline of superior longitudinal. Transversus inguinal, where the fibers are oriented, transverse to the median fibrous septa. This is one wall in the middle of the tongue. Verticalis inguinal, from the upper surface to lower surface of the tongue. The mucous membrane from upper surface to lower surface, it will be vertical, right? So it's called verticalis inguinal. So in intrinsic muscles, their action can be one of these. Either it lengthens the tongue or shortens the tongue. Either it curls the tongue or uncurls the tongue. Either it flattens the tongue or rounds the surface of the tongue. So these are the possible action of these intrinsic muscles. Coming to the inferior longitudinal muscle, it is one of the intrinsic muscle. So location, of course, which is within the tongue, in the lower portion, oriented longitudinally. Okay. Coming to the origin and insertion of this muscle, inferior longitudinal muscle of the tongue. The origin of this muscle is from the wall. The wall is called as median fibrous septa. It is the anterior portion of the median fibrous septa from where it takes origin. Insertion is to the mucous membrane of the tongue, and that will be diverging backwards towards the dorsum and inserted to the mucous membrane of the tongue. So this is the orientation of inferior longitudinal on one side, other side will be like this. So from the tip it is diverging backwards. So what do you think happens when this longitudinal muscle contracts? What can happen? Can it flatten the tongue? Will it become convex? Will it shorten the tongue or will it lengthen the tongue? If you are told shortens the tongue, then it's a correct answer. So this inferior longitudinal muscle, upon contraction, it will shorten the tongue. So when it shortens the tongue, the food or whatever ice cream or any stuff what you are eating will enter your oral cavity. So that is a basic action. In addition to that, the dorsum of the tongue, this surface, the upper surface of the tongue, will become convex. So it will go and touch the palate. Like a wave in the ocean, this upper surface will become convex. Come to the nerve supply of this inferior longitudinal muscle. It is by one of the nerve which is going underneath the tongue. It's called as hypoglossal nerve or the 12th cranial nerve. In fact, all the muscles of the tongue are supplied by this nerve, hypoglossal nerve or the 12th cranial nerve, except this muscle. This muscle, can I guess what is this? If you've seen my previous videos. This is palate and this is tongue, palatoglossus. So except the palatoglossus, all the other muscles are supplied by 12th cranial nerve or hypoglossal nerve. Whereas the palatoglossus is supplied by 11th cranial nerve or accessory nerve. In summary, the intrinsic muscles are 4 in number on either side of tongue, superior longitudinal muscle, inferior longitudinal muscle, transversus linguae, verticalis linguae. This is the base and this is the tip. They are oriented from the base towards the tip, longitudinally. One is above, one is below, therefore superior and inferior longitudinal. From the median fibrous septa, if they are going horizontally on either side towards the lateral margins of the tongue, it will be called transversus linguae. From the upper surface of the tongue towards the lower surface of the tongue, it is going vertically down, right? So it's called verticalis linguae. So these are the intrinsic muscles of this tongue. And all of them are supplied by 12th cranial nerve or hypoglossal nerve. Like and share this video with your family and friends. Don't forget to press the thumbs up button. Ask your queries in the comment section so that I can answer that. Subscribe to my channel and press the bell button to get the latest notification of video. Thanks. Thank you once again.